Standing Committee on Consumer Protection, I'm Senator David Carlucci, the chairman. We're joined by our ranker, Senator Comrie. We have Senator Brooks with us, Senator Funky, and Senator Amador, all present. So with that, we'll get started with the first bill on the agenda. The first bill, at the Senator Funky's request, we're going to be laying aside that bill for today. So we're going to move to the next bill, 1236 by Senator Valesky.
An act to amend the general business law in relation to the sale of over-the-counter methamphetamine precursor drugs. This bill passed the Senate in 2015 and 2016.
Do we have a motion?
I move.
Moved by Senator Amador, seconded by Senator Comrie, and this bill, 1236, is referred to rules. Our next bill on the calendar is Bill 1250 by Senator Axcar.
An act to amend the general business law in relation to prohibiting the sale, manufacture, or possession of flamethrowers.
Do we have a motion? Moved by Senator Brooks, seconded by Senator Comrie, and Senate Bill 1250 is referred to rules. Next bill is Senator Bill 2085 by Senator Comrie.
An act to amend the general business law in relation to requiring warnings on certain lithium batteries and products containing such batteries.
Moved by Senator Brooks, seconded by Senator Funky, and this bill is referred to rules. Next bill, 5152 by Senator Sabina.
An act to amend the personal property law in relation to loan assignees. This bill passed the Senate in 2015 and 2016.
Moved by Senator Comrie, seconded by Senator Funky, and this bill is referred to rules. Senate Bill 5152 is referred to rules. Next bill on the calendar is Senate Bill 5282 by Senator Lanza.
An act to amend the general business law in relation to exempting certain officers of the Departments of Correction and Sanitation of the City of New York from training requirements for security guards, and to amend the criminal procedure law in relation to designating correction officers of New York City as peace officers. This bill passed the Senate in 2015 and 2016.
Moved by Senator Funky, seconded by Senator Comrie, and Senate Bill 5282 is referred to rules. Next bill on the calendar is Senate Bill 5603A by Senator Carlucci.
An act to amend the general business law in relation to prohibiting the disclosure of personally identifiable information by an internet service provider without express written approval of the consumer. There's a memo of support from my group.
Explanation on this.
So currently, right now, consumers are automatically opted into advertising and tracking programs by the internet service provider. They do not have to provide consent, and internet service providers can use this information when they collect this information, they use it to for various advertising-related purposes. And the issue right now is that consumers have no say in whether or not they want to participate in these advertising programs. It's not to say that the programs don't have any use, it's just that a consumer should have a choice.
So, a choice of being followed, figuring out the demographics or the type of consumer segments that the individual is surfing?
Well, for example, you can use the browsing history of any user who's accessing the internet, and from that information, an internet service provider is able to determine what an individual is going through at their personal point, entirely throughout their entire browsing history, or at a certain point in time during their life. They can use that information to market products to them. So when you're browsing something on the internet and you see you look at a specific topic or a product, then you find out like a day or two later other products related to what you were searching are being marketed to you without your consent.
Mm-hmm. It's kind of like the mailbox though, isn't it? Snail mail. You get mail sent to you that you didn't even realize, nor do you want. And so what do you do there? Are we going to legislate that from happening?
Well, we have, in a similar way, we have a do not call list. And you can participate, and you can get your name, you'll get your number added to that do not call list.
Do not call list is a lot different than what I think this bill is here. So maybe well-intentioned, but I won't be voting in the negative.
Thank you. I'm a no on that one.
Moved by Senator Brooks, second by Senator Comrie. And Senate Bill 5603 is referred to rules. Next bill is Senate Bill 5653 by Senator Klein.
An act to amend the general business law and the labor law in relation to the use of consumer credit reports for employment decisions.
Explanation.
This bill is basically, so right now, employers are allowed to use a employee's credit history, a credit report, to determine whether or not they're eligible for to be hired, fired, or promoted. This bill would basically prevent that, would prohibit that practice.
Using a credit report?
Yes, to make hiring, firing, or promotional decisions.
So if they were being hired, if the candidate was being hired for a financial institution position, and they're dealing with finances of someone else, they look at the credit report and credit history, because that just shows not just a number, but it also shows some history of the individual. You don't think that the employer should have that information at their disposal?
There hasn't been any correlation between a credit report and credit history compared to job performance. Some people are better managing other people's money.
I understand. I wouldn't disagree. I don't disagree with that. I think that an employer has a very difficult decision to make when it comes to filling positions. In certain positions, an employer needs every resource possible to determine the right candidate for the right position in the job. I don't think government should be telling someone who and what and how and what information they have access to determine whether they could hire or not an individual. So I don't think that this legislation is necessary, and I think it's wrong, and I'll be voting in the negative.
Thank you, Senator Amador. Any other questions on the bill? Do we have a motion? Moved by Senator Conrad, second by Senator Brooks. And Senate Bill 5653 is referred to rules. Next bill on the calendar, 6088 by Senator Savino.
An act to amend the general business law in relation to licensing of hair removal technicians. There's a memo of support from the Society for Clinical and Medical Hair Removal.
Do we have a motion? Moved by Senator Funke, seconded by Senator Comrie. And Senate Bill 6088 is referred to rules. Next bill on the calendar, Senate Bill 6508 by Senator Carlucci.
An act to amend the general business law in relation to requiring online marketplaces to provide a product recall search web form.
Do we have a motion? Moved by Senator Comrie, seconded by Senator Brooks. This bill is referred to rules.
AWR.
Okay. Any other business? Well, with that, the committee meeting is adjourned. Thank you so much. See you soon.